if it has a form A, B, 0, B, A, 0, 0, 0, C. It will have three eigenvalues. Since it is a 3 by 3 matrix, it should have three eigenvalues. What are those values? C. Here C is there. C and A plus or minus B. This is also same. A plus B is an eigenvalue and A minus B is the third eigenvalue. And the trick number 3 is rows or columns are identical or same. I'll explain this. Just consider this matrix. All the numbers are same. So I can say all the rows are same or all the columns are same. If it is in this form, then what will be the eigenvalue? Trace of that matrix and 0, 0. I hope you know how to find the trace. Sum of the principal diagonal elements. Here 1 plus 1 plus 1, 3. So for this matrix, eigenvalue will be 3, 0, 0. Here that 0, 0 is degenerate eigenvalue. What is mean by degenerate or degeneracy? Two eigenvalues are same. If two eigenvalues are same, then we will say it as a degenerate eigenvalue. This is for same matrix. The same trick is valid for identical matrix or similar matrix. Just look at this matrix. Here, first row is AAA and second row 111. I can relate the first row and second row as row 1 is equal to A into row 2. If I can relate like this, then also I can apply this trick. Lambda equal to trace minus 0, 0. Here I have, you know, trace is the A plus 4. Principal diagonal elements, A plus 1 plus 3. So I will get A plus 4, 0, 0. And the fourth trick, skew symmetric matrix. Yesterday I have explained what is skew symmetric matrix. A transpose is equal to minus A. That is the condition for skew symmetric matrix. And if a skew symmetric matrix is given, then its eigenvalue will be like this. 0, plus or minus I, under root A squared plus B squared plus C squared. These are the values, A, B, C. Of course, for skew symmetric matrix, it will be minus A, minus B, minus C. So 0, plus or minus 1, under root A squared plus B squared plus C squared. It has three eigenvalues. Since it is 3 by 3, we will get three eigenvalues plus I into this term. Plus I into this squared term and minus I into this squared term. So these are the values. I will give you the fifth trick. Remember, this trick is applicable only for 3 by 3 matrix. The fourth trick is applicable only for 3 by 3 skew symmetric matrix. You cannot apply for 4 by 4. Or 2 by 2. Okay. The fifth one is
Participants, note down these kind of important tricks that Arvind is giving out. It will be useful for you in the future. You may forget these kind of things when you are storing it in your memory. Writing in a notepad would help you to recall these things. So kindly note down these points. Thank you.
So have a look at this matrix. Here only the diagonal elements are non-zero. This is a diagonal element, and of course this is also a diagonal element. This diagonal elements are non-zero. For these kind of matrix, the eigenvalues will look like this. 0, A, 2A. Of course this has to be same. All the diagonal elements should be same. And sixth one. just we are going to invert this, which means only off diagonal elements are non-zero and diagonal elements are zero. Zero. Engla a irko angla zero porru engla zero irko adu a mathram. So for this type, eigenvalues are root 2 into a. The root on the 2 madna. So these are the six tricks. One second, just have a look. Based on this, we can solve any question without using pen and paper. Now we are going to do that. Do you have any doubt?
Could you give a quick recap on these tricks so that recently joined participants could also be able to grasp the things? A quick recap.
Okay. So these are the tricks which help you to solve eigenvalue problems without using pen and paper. So first trick is you have to remember this form, this matrix form, and this eigenvalues. Just two things. Look at the matrix form and remember the eigenvalue form. So if it is in the form A, B, B, A, then eigenvalues are A plus B, comma A minus B. And simply I have written A plus or minus B. And the second one, the same thing, but it is for 3x3 matrix. A, B, 0, B, A, 0, 0, 0, C. If it is in this form, we will get the eigenvalues as C, comma A plus or minus B. And the third one, it is important one. If the two rows or columns, if any rows or columns are same or identical. Same means all the values are equal. Identical means we can relate like this. R1 equal to A into R2 in this case. So if it is in this form, then the eigenvalues are trace of that matrix and all the remaining eigenvalues are zero. It is applicable for any order, not only for 3x3 or 2x2, for any order, n by n, we can use this one. And the fourth one, skew symmetric matrix. In the last class, I have explained what is skew symmetric. A equal to, A transpose equal to minus A. That is the condition for skew symmetric matrix. So for skew symmetric matrix, the eigenvalues look like this. Lambda equal to 0 comma plus or minus 1 under root A squared plus B squared plus C squared. Fifth one. If all the diagonal elements are same and off diagonal elements are zero, diagonal elements I have marked in a blue color, then the eigenvalues are 0 comma A comma 2A. And the last one, if all the diagonal elements are zero and off diagonal elements are same, non-zero number and it should be same, then the eigenvalues look like this. 0, plus or minus 2 to A. So anybody having any doubt in this 6 tricks, please ask. If you have any doubt, please ask. Otherwise, we will solve the questions. If you don't have any doubt, please mention in the chat box. No doubt. Okay, enough. So I will. Have you write down these tricks on your notebook? Okay, good. So I will give you the questions you are going to solve using this trick. Can everybody see the question clearly? My first question is, what kind of matrix is this? Which type of matrix is this? This question was asked in June 2014. CSA net, June 2014. QC matrix, very good, very good. Yeah, then what is the trick for skew-symmetric matrix? Apply that trick and tell me which option is correct. See, we are not going to form any characteristic equation. Just using the trick, we are going to tell the answer. Come on, quick. I got only three responses. What about remaining people? Are you trying or doing some other things? Okay, so B is the right answer. What is the trick? If it is skew symmetric matrix, then 0, comma plus or minus I, plus or minus I under root A square plus B square plus C square. This is the trick. What are the values of A, B, C? A is 2i, B is 3i, C is 6i. I hope you know I is square root of minus 1, imaginary number. So 0 comma plus or minus I under root A squared, that is 2I squared plus B squared, that is 3I squared plus C squared, 6I squared. So 0 comma plus or minus I under root square root of I squared is equal to minus 1. So here we will get minus 4, minus 9, minus 36. This is equal to minus 49. I can write plus or minus I into 7. Same thing, minus root 1, root of minus 1 equal to I. So I can write this as I into 7, because root of 49 is 7. I will get I into I, again minus 1. So 7 minus 7. Okay, hope you understand this one. Let's move on to the second question. And this is the second question. And this was asked in the year 2012, June 2012. What trick do we need to use? Trick number which one? Everyone can see the question clearly. Trick 3, good. Then what is the answer? good, good. So for trick 3, one eigenvalue will be equal to trace and remaining eigenvalues are 0. Using that, we can straight away tell that the fourth option is the right answer. For this question, they are giving 3.5 marks. Okay, we will do next question. Question number 3, I think. This is also a CSER question and asking 2012, the same year. Okay, what type of matrix is this? Oh, they have mentioned anti-symmetric matrix. Anti-symmetric in the sense skew symmetric, they are same. One more term for skew symmetric is anti-symmetric. So don't get confused. Don't think I have not told that. So it is skew symmetric matrix. Okay, so what is that trick? All the values are 0. No, I think you would have not understood that n1, n2, n3 are the components of unit vector. What is mean by unit vector? You can give a two-word answer. What is mean by unit vector? Anybody knows? You can unmute your mic and tell the answer. Magnitude is 1. Yeah, good. Good. Magnitude is 1. So if they have given n1, n2, n3 are the components of unit vector. I will write that unit vector now. N1 I cap plus n2 j cap plus n3 k cap. So this is how that vector will look like. And how to find the magnitude of a vector? Under root n1 squared plus n2 squared plus n3 squared. So this is how we have to find the magnitude of any vector. It is n1 is nothing but a component along x-axis, n2 component along y-axis, n3 z-axis. So n1 squared plus n2 squared plus n3 squared. This is the magnitude of that unit vector. And this is equal to 1. For unit vector, this should be equal to 1. I think now you can give me the answers. Okay, so I will write the trick for a skew symmetric matrix, that is anti-symmetric matrix, 0, comma plus or minus I under root a square plus b square plus c square. Here n1 square plus n2 square plus n3 square. Since it is a component of unit vector, then this root term, square root of n1 square plus n2 square plus n3 square, should be equal to 1. That is the meaning of this line. So I will write 0 comma plus or minus I into 1. So first option is the right answer. Anybody having doubt in this third question? Any doubt in this third question? No. Okay. So I will give you one more question. This is fourth one. Come on, straight away you can give me the answer without taking any time. Yeah, good, good. This question was asked in the year. June 2011. This question was asked in June 2011. Okay. And I'll give one more question. This was asked in GATE exam. In GATE exam, they used to do. Sorry. In GATE exam, there are. We need to sum up the questions. We need to enter the answers. It is visible. So this is a type of question in which we have to enter the value. What type of matrix is this? What can we do? Okay, I will come back to this fifth question later on. Okay, we'll discuss this fifth question later. Now do the sixth one. What is the answer for sixth one? Just now don't think about fifth question, just do the sixth one. I'll come back to this later on. that second trick.
Akash has raised his hand. Clarify if he has any doubt.
You can unmute and ask his question.
Sir, excuse me, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, actually, in the sixth sum, I don't have enough idea to use the trick number two, sir. So, can you explain the sum, sir?
Why don't you have the idea?
Sir, actually, lambda is equal to C, comma A plus R, B, right, sir? That is
yes,
a trick,
yes. I think. Yes.
So, lambda is equal to C, in the sense, it will be obviously 1.
Okay.
Then A plus R, B, in the sense, if I assume...
What is A?
A is equal to 2.
Okay.
And B is 3.
Okay.
So A plus R B in the sense
A plus B is eigenvalue, A minus B is eigenvalue. What is A plus B?
5, sir.
A minus B?
Minus 1.
Then which option?
Okay, sir. Option C. Okay. Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Seventh question. This is also a gate question, and this is also a gate. A 3x3 matrix has elements such that it traces 11 and determinant is 36. Then the eigenvalues of the matrix are all known to be positive integers, the largest eigenvalue of the matrix. For this question, I have given the idea in the last class itself. Okay, see, you have to find out three numbers. If you add that three numbers, you have to get 11. If you multiply that three numbers, you have to get 36. Then what are the three numbers? All three should be positive. You have to find out three numbers. If you add that three numbers, you must get 11. If you multiply that three numbers, you must get 36. Tell me all the possible eigenvalues. Two, three, six. Yeah. Then which one is largest value? Sixth one. Okay. Fine. I will give you one more question. This was asked in just exam. Eighth question. Understand the question and tell me the answer. All the elements are 1. Then one eigenvalue is equal to trace and remaining eigenvalues are 0. So, okay, I will ask one more question from this 8th one. How many degenerate eigenvalues are there? How many degenerate eigenvalues are there? n minus 1 is the answer. If it is n by n matrix, then it must have n eigenvalues. Out of that n eigenvalue, one eigenvalue is non-zero, which is equal to n. And remaining eigenvalues are zero. So totally how many zeros are there? N minus 1 zeros will be there. So if they ask how many degenerate eigenvalues are there, you must tell that n minus 1. I will give you one more question. This is 9th question. This is also from GIST. Here, this A we don't know. Kindly please give your answer with question number, because if I see the comment, I'm getting A, B, B, C, C. I don't know for which questions. What is the third eigenvalue? They are not asking the value of A, but what is the third eigenvalue? Okay, let me solve this one using that last class idea, which is nothing but trace equal to sum of eigenvalues. Here, what is the trace? A plus 4. We need to add all the principal diagonal elements. So, sorry, A plus 3 is the trace, and that should be equal to sum of eigenvalues. Here, two eigenvalues we know, but the third eigenvalue we don't know. I'm going to assume it as x. So, x plus 1 minus 1. This will be equal to x. So, I have got idea that a plus 3 is equal to x. Okay. So, using that first idea, sum of eigenvalues equal to trace, I came to this equation. Then, I will apply one more thing, that is product of eigenvalues is equal to determinant. What is the product of eigenvalues? I have assumed that the third eigenvalue is x. So product of eigenvalues. Determinant is equal to product of eigenvalues. Pi over I means it's product. For sum, we will write a sigma. For product, we will write pi. So here, minus 1 into 1 into x. So this is equal to minus x. So determinant of this matrix is equal to minus x. Can anyone tell me what is the determinant of this matrix? Determinant of this matrix. A minus 9. Good. retake this 1 and 2 into a minus 9 we will get. Okay. So what is the determinant? 2a minus 9 equal to minus x. So I have two equations. I have two equations. A plus 3 equal to x and 2a minus 9. This is 9. 2a minus 9 equal to minus x. Using this two equation, we need to find the value of x. This is a simple one. Hope you know this. I can write a equal to x minus 3. Just substitute the value of a in the second equation. 2 into x minus 3 minus 9 equal to minus x. 2x minus 6 minus 9 equal to minus x. 3x equal to 15 and x equal to 5. So the third eigenvalue is 5. Then it's option, second option. Okay. Do you have any doubt in this ninth question? A equal to 2, x equal to 5. Good. Okay. If you want, you can try it out. I will give one more question. It is a very, very tough question. It was asked in GATE exam. GATE 2005. Very old question too. Let me write the matrix. 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, minus 2i. So this is the matrix, 4 by 4 matrix. And they ask, what are the eigenvalues? Eigenvalues. I'll give you the options. I'll give you the options. Minus 2, minus 1. Since it is a 4 by 4 matrix, so it must have 4 eigenvalues. Second one, minus 1, 1, 0, 2. Third option, 1, 0, 2, 3. Fourth option. I don't know how many of you understand this tough question. 10A. Yeah. Which idea you have to use? Sum of eigenvalues is equal to trace. Though it looks like a big matrix, this trace is zero. So we have to look at the options. This is the only way to do this problem. Forming a characteristic equation, then find out value from this. It's a very, very difficult task. So in most of the exams, they used to give options like this only. Based on the options, we need to find the answer. Not always we need to proceed with question. Sometimes we have to do with the options. That is the smart way to answer. So here, what is the trace? Zero. Then if we add all the eigenvalues, we must get zero. In which of the four options that is possible? Look at the first option. -2, -1, +1, +2. If we add all the four, we will get 0. Look at the second one. So it is possible. Just look at the second one. -1, +1, 0, 2. If we add all the values, we will get 2, not 0. Similarly here, non-zero value, six, we will get 6. Here, we will get 3. So in three options, we don't get 0. Only one option, we are getting 0. This is how they used to form a question and give the options. Don't think they will give all the values or add up to 0. They won't give like that. So answer for this question is option A. Okay, I will give one more. Anybody having doubt in this 10th one? 10th question. This is also again from KHF. 2004. (1i - i1). What are the eigenvalues? Do you want options? No, I'm not going to give the options. You please tell me the answer. (1i - i1). What are the eigenvalues? It will have two eigenvalues. What are they? I want to know how many of you have understood clearly. 1, -1. How can you get 3 eigenvalues with the 2x2 matrix? I don't get your answer. What is here? 0, 2. Everybody must answer. I will tell the answer only after getting all your responses. If you don't know, no problem. asking those who have listened, have given your answers. Now I will give you the options and try to give which is right. -1, -0, -1, -0, -2, -1, +1. Always remember that two things: sum of eigenvalues is equal to trace, product of eigenvalues is equal to determinant. It is applicable for all the matrix, all the order. So use that and tell me the answer. It is one of the simplest problem. What is the trace here? Trace is 2. So obviously two options are wrong. Which one? B and D are wrong options. When we add D, we will get 0. When we add B, we will get 1. So definitely B and D are not the right answers. Okay. Then what is the determinant here? 1 into 1. Okay, if we find the determinant, I hope you know how many of you know how to find the determinant. Here 1 minus of minus I into plus I. This is equal to 1 minus of minus, sorry, this is plus 1. 1 minus 1 equal to 0. Minus I into I is equal to plus 1. So 1 minus 1, 0. Then the determinant is equal to 0. Then if we multiply that two numbers, we must get 0. Obviously, option C. When we add two numbers, we must get 2. When we multiply two numbers, we must get 0. Determinant is 0. You must revise every day whatever you learned. Otherwise, you will forget. Anybody having doubt in this 11th question? Some of you have given 1 plus I, 1 minus I. I don't know. How did you give? Don't seek for tricks always. Sometimes you need to do with the basics. In the first trick, you apply it. The A, B, B, A form. So, that's what you need to do with the number. Okay, do you want break? I think 1 hour I just need.
Yeah, sure, sure, Arvind. You have a short 10 minutes break. If everyone wish to have, kindly reply in the chat so that we may have a break or we will continue.
I want break, so 10 minutes break.
Okay, okay, Arvind. Okay, sure. Okay, Arvind, you will only left. Others, you can give a question to others. So, whoever wish to stay in the session will stay in the session and solve the question. Yeah. Okay, participants who are all in the session without going break, kindly revise today's concepts and tricks that he has given to you. If you forgot to note down, kindly note down now. Okay, sixth trick, sir. Could anyone answer the sixth trick for Surya Narayanan? Guys who are all in the session, could you kindly say the sixth trick to Surya Narayanan so that he will be able to get that one? So the trainer is on mute. He is on break, so he won't be able to write on the board. So one of the participants, just explain the sixth trick only. Oh, last question. Okay. The 11th question, I think, right? It was a simple question. Just look at the question. To find out the eigenvalues, you need two things, right? Forget about the tricks that he has taught, because the trick won't apply here, because A, B, B, A is the trick that he has taught you, but here is A, B, minus B and A. So the trick won't apply here. So on seeing the question itself, the trick failed. So you have to try some other ways to solve this. So use the basic tricks that sum of the diagonal elements is the trace and the determinant, and get the determinant of the matrix. So the sum of the trace elements is 2. Like the diagonal elements is 1 and 1, adding 1 and 1 gives 2. And the determinant gives a 0 value. Multiplying 1 and 1 is 1. And I into I is equal to my I squared. I squared is minus 1. Minus into minus plus. So it will give a 0. So determinant is 0 and the trace is 2. So in the options below, see whichever options is up to these two values. Option C is the only one opt for trace equal to 2 and determinant is equal to 0. So obviously option C is the right answer. Could you get this one, Shobana? Don't go for a characteristic equation. Just try to solve using basics and tricks. If it is hard to solve using basics and tricks, you can go for the characteristic equation. I think I have explained it clearly. If you got my point, kindly reply yes. Or if you have any clarifications in what I have said, kindly ask so that I'll be make it clear to you. Oh, thank you, Shobana. And Surya Srinivasan is asking that sixth trick that I think he's forgot to note down, I guess. So anyone who is note down it in your notepad, kindly tell him in the chat for the sixth trick so that he will be able to get that one.
Shall I explain the sixth trick?
Sure, you can explain.
Am I audible? Able to hear? Hello?
Yes, you are audible. Kindly explain.
Sixth trick is, it's easy only. The non-diagonal elements should be same. And the diagonal elements have to be zero. So that is what it is given there. So the diagonal elements are all zero and the non-diagonal elements should be identical. So then we can use this trick to find the eigenvalues. So that is lambda is equal to 0, square root of 2a and minus square root of 2a. Is that clear? Hello? Lambda value is
okay. Could you?
And plus or minus square root of 2a.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I guess.
It's okay. Welcome. Thank you.
Okay. I guess Surya Nara Srinivasan is clear now. If you are not clear, ask super. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Surya. I'm happy that you are all clearly understood the sessions and making note of them. Kindly recall the things that you have gone through till now today. In another 5 minutes, the session will resume and you will get some more problems and some other topics to cover today. Is anyone having any other doubts or questions to ask? You can ask now. Feel free to ask. You can unmute and ask. If you are going to unmute, kindly raise your hand so that others won't unmute and talk. So it would be a some kind of noise would be there. So some two or three people ask at the same time. So raise your hand and ask whatever you are willing to ask. Feel free to ask. You have to be interactive to learn things. Sure, Mayalagan. I'll send the registration link and the feedback link at the end of the session. So don't bother about that. I think it's a must to register because we don't know your details and your name because you are joining through your friends link or some other options. So registration is important. And feedback is also important because we considered it the previous day. It's okay that if you are not given the feedback, but today try to give the feedback. If anyone having any other doubts or clarification or anything, you can ask. We're gonna clear them now. Sure, ask Madhusia.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, ma'am.
Sir, actually, I'm attending the session only by today because yesterday's session, I'm totally not aware of it. So, I don't know what was actually taught in the previous class, I think the last class. So, anybody, can you give a gist or at least the name of the topics which sir taught in the last class? In the sense, it will be easy for me to just continue. This is my question, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you.
I appreciate your interest. Could anybody give a gist or a quick recap of the topics or concepts you have learned yesterday with the tricks? Okay, if you want to explain, kindly unmute and explain to her so that she will be able to get it clearly. Okay, I guess no one is available to explain, I think. Okay, Madhusia, yesterday the class was about basics of matrix and the eigenvalues, how to find trace, and types of matrix. That was the yesterday's session. Okay, I guess the break is over. Sure, Sendamil Raja. We are not posting it in YouTube because we must take responsibility to respond those candidates who are asking questions in the YouTube also. So we don't have that much time to concentrate on YouTube. So we are recording this from today onwards. We will plan something to get you use these videos in the future. But I guess till now there are no options on using these recorded videos. We'll try in the future. Arvind, thanks for your quick back. Could you kindly recall the yesterday's topic in a 2-minute duration? A candidate or an aspirant asked, because she's unaware of this session yesterday, so she joined only today. It will be helpful for her.
Okay, I just discussed about types of matrix and eigenvalues, how to find eigenvalues. At the end of the session, I'll send you the notes to you. I don't know that name. Please mention your email ID. I'll send you the notes to your email ID. You can refer that.
Also needs kindly reply him with your mail ID. Mention myself. We will get to you in contact.
So again, let's start. Anybody having doubt up to this 11th problem? Except the 5th one. Any doubt? Okay, good. I'll give you 12th one. This was asked in IIT JAM 2019 last. Again, eigenvalue problem. I'll give you the options now. You have to find the eigenvalues, and the options are two comma four comma six and 2i. 4i and 6. Third option is 2i, 4, comma 8, 0, comma 4, comma 8. Come on. Everybody must send your answers. Before sending the answer, please cross check whether that is right or wrong. You are too much interested in learning. So with your eagerness, you are making some mistakes. Avoid that. In exams also, you will repeat the same. Here we are not able to use any tricks. The only thing is sum of eigenvalues is equal to trace and product of eigenvalues is equal to determinant. So based on that first point, sum of eigenvalues is equal to trace, we can eliminate two options. Straight away we can eliminate two options. Because we are getting complex numbers when we add option B and C. So definitely option B and C are not the right answers. Using second trick, that is product of eigenvalues is equal to determinant, we can come to a conclusion. What is the determinant here? Determinant for this matrix. Yeah, good. So in third option, zero is there. So determinant will become zero. If third option is right, sorry, fourth option is right, then determinant will become zero. But in the matrix, determinant is not equal to zero. Then obviously, first option is the right answer. Option A is right. I will summarize the eigenvalue topic. First one, sum of eigenvalues. Equal to trace. Second point, product of eigenvalues equal to determinant. And third point, if lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 are the eigenvalues of A, then for A transpose, transpose of that A is the eigenvalue for A transpose. Hope you know how to find A transpose. A transpose is also same. Lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3. So if lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 are the eigenvalues of A, then for A transpose also, eigenvalues will be lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3. Then for A power m, it will be lambda power m, sorry, lambda 1 power m, lambda 2 power m, lambda 3 power m. And fourth one, eigenvalue of diagonal matrix. Last class I have explained what is diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrix is diagonal elements. Eigenvalues, values of diagonal matrix or diagonal elements. This is applicable for triangular matrix also. Eigenvalues of triangular matrix, whether it is upper triangle or lower triangle, same trick. Also diagonal elements. eigen values of Hermitian matrix is always real. Always real values. You won't get any I terms in the eigenvalues for Hermitian matrix. Eigenvalues of anti-Hermitian matrix. Always zero are purely imaginary. So remember these 7 points. First one, sum of eigenvalues is equal to trace, product of eigenvalues is equal to determinants. If lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 are the eigenvalues of A, then the eigenvalues for A transpose is also equal to lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3. Of course, A power m is given, then it should be equal to lambda power m, lambda 1 power m, lambda 2 power m, lambda 3 power m. This m can be any value, 1, 2, 5, 50, minus 1, anything. And fourth point, eigenvalues of diagonal matrix are diagonal elements. Eigenvalues of triangular matrix are also diagonal elements. Principal diagonal elements. These diagonal elements in the sense principal diagonal elements. Eigenvalues of Hermitian matrix is always real. And eigenvalues of anti-Hermitian matrix are always zero or pure imaginary numbers. With this point, if you can answer a few more questions, I'll give you now. Take that's question number 13. This is as in CSA net. Eigenvalues of Hermitian matrix are real. The sixth point. It must be always real number. I think it is 13th question. Okay, what will be the number? Oh, okay. 13th question. This was asking CSA net exam. I'll give one more question. I don't know the year. And now I'll give you 14th question. This is also asking CSA. Next. Come on. Using the summary points, you can answer this one. PR mean trace of matrix M equal to 6, trace of matrix M squared equal to 26, trace of matrix M cube equal to 90. Then what will be the eigenvalues of M? it and give me the answer. December 2011. 3x3 matrix is there. Its trace is 6. Let's check the answer. First eliminate, I think all the options are possible. If we use the trick number one, we will get all the options are possible. Because when we add all the options, we will get 6. So there is no use of using trick one. That is sum of eigenvalues is equal to trace. Then we'll go with m squared. We need to do with the trial and error method. What is mean by trial and error method? I am going to assume option one is right answer and I will proceed with that. Let's check whether it is the right answer or not. It can be the trace of matrix M, since if I add all the numbers, I will get 6. Then what about M squared? For M squared, it will be 1 squared and 4 squared. That is equal to 1, 1, 16. If I add all these numbers, will I get 26? I won't get 26. So sum of eigenvalues is equal to trace. Here these are the eigenvalues for m squared. If I add all these values, I won't get 26. So first option is not the answer. Then go with second. Similarly for a 1 squared, 0 squared and 7 squared. I will get 1049. If I add all the numbers, will I get 26? No, I won't get. So this also not possible. Go with third option. 1 squared, minus 1 squared, 3 squared, 4 squared. What will I get? 1, 9, 16. If I add all the three numbers, will I get 26? Yeah, it's possible to get 26. So this should be the answer. Okay. Give one more question. So think about it. This was asked in GATE 2014. What is the condition for orthogonal matrix? What is the condition for symmetric matrix and anti-symmetric unitary matrix? You must check each and everything. Otherwise, take it as homework and do it. In the first class, I have explained what is an orthogonal matrix, what is symmetric matrix, what is anti-symmetric, what is unitary matrix. So using that, you have to check which option is correct for this matrix A. Take your time and think and give me the answer. Okay, simple. 16th problem is too simple. See, we need to form a characteristic equation. How will we get characteristic equation? Lambda square minus trace lambda. What is trace here? Zero. Lambda square minus trace lambda plus determinant. Then write the formula. Lambda squared minus trace into lambda plus determinant equal to zero. Lambda squared minus what is trace here? Zero. Zero into lambda plus determinant. What is the determinant here? Zero minus of minus one plus one. Plus one equal to zero. So I'll get lambda squared plus one equal to zero. So lambda squared equal to minus one. Lambda equal to plus or minus I. So it is complex and distinct. Distinct means different values. Okay, take this 15th problem as homework and do it. So with this we are came to end of this class. If you have any doubt from previous classes or this class, you can ask me now. Any doubt up to this? Unmute your mic and ask.
Thank you. Guys, for this class, kindly repeat that and give your feedbacks in the form. For notes of the previous class, kindly mention need notes in the text area of the feedback. So we will contact you further. Thank you. You can proceed, Arvind.
anyone is having doubt, you can ask.